614 Startups Nation, welcome back to the red carpet. I don't normally do introductions, but I got a legend in the building, okay? And I've coined a nickname for this guy right here. All right, to me, this is Alex ASAP Fro Frohmeyer. What's up, bud?
I love the growl and I love the nickname. I love it.
Now, Fro, you started a company, Beam Dental, that's making a lot of waves, but may not be on everybody's radar right now. So tell us a bit about Beam Dental.
So Beam Dental is a tech-enabled dental insurance company. Just crossed 200 employees, which we're really excited about because we started the year at 50 or 60. And our focus is on making dental insurance a product that nobody's thinking about. It's kind of a back of your mind thing if you're an employer and offering benefits to your employees. We want to turn it into a delightful, beautiful, automated experience. And that's what we're focused on day to day.
That's terrific. Now, you're an alumnus, right? You've been on the 614 Startups podcast, and I know you're a Louisville kid, or at least from across the border, right? And so you chose to locate your company in Ohio, specifically in Columbus. So recap that decision for us. What was that decision making like, and what attracted you to want to grow a company in Ohio?
Just like Louisville's native son, Muhammad Ali, needed to grow and grow beyond the city of Louisville. When back in 2014, we wanted to grow. We wanted to build a product and a company and a service that would go to tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of people. And we knew we needed capital to do that. And we were really fortunate in that time when nearly all of the capital was on the coast, and it still is. But in that day, when we wanted to, and needed capital, we were really fortunate to meet Drive Capital, who had just gotten started and was, of course, in Columbus. And they really turned us on to the community here. And so they're the reason why we became aware of Columbus as a place where startups can grow and thrive and develop. And as I started coming up here more and more back in 2014, meeting with Drive and learning more about the community, it became clear that this was the place where we could do what we've now done and build a 200 plus person company and something that's now on the radar and growing quickly on a national scale.
Right. When you say sexy, you don't immediately think dental insurance, right? That's not on the list of things, but dental health is critical. Let's talk to founders out there who might be thinking, oh, my business needs to be sexy to attract investors, needs to be sexy to scale. Where do you think the problem solving, actually addressing an issue, needs to come into play?
This is a great question. This is why you get paid the big bucks to do what you do. I think one of the biggest misconceptions in how the market, and the market is in a broad sense for how founders and investors and the tech community thinks. The market wants you to believe that the only types of companies worth building is today's trend. And if you notice, and if you pay any attention to this at all, today's trend changes. Every year, it's crypto, it's AI, it's machine learning. 5 years ago, it was the Internet of Things. 5 years before that, it was e-commerce. 5 years before that, it was social, whatever. There's always a new trend. And founders get tricked into thinking that the only type of company worth building is today's trend. But the reality is, there are so many markets and problems to solve and customers to find that you can carve out a phenomenal business. Maybe it's a venture-backable business. Maybe it's just a great company. There's so many problems to solve and things to do. And I am a huge fan of using my company and others that I know as proof positive that you don't need to be in a sexy industry. You don't need to be in a traditional tech industry.
Or grow cannabis.
Right, yeah. You need to be solving a problem for a customer, and if you have a unique angle on a problem to solve, that is what should start your company.
Yeah, now all startup stories are not a straight line, right? So you didn't set out to start an insurance company. You needed to build one because there was a need. So let's talk about the pivot, right? In that critical point in the business where you recognize, hey, I'm building something, but the need is different and I need to pivot.
As I said before, great companies start, any company should start with a problem to solve. And the problem that we saw to solve was that dental insurance to us looked broken. My co-founders and I, when we were first getting started, the way we wanted to solve that problem was to build a data company and a technology company and a software company with the first connected toothbrush. And so the value of the connected toothbrush was to get behavioral data that we could use to understand how preventative care would impact claims consumption and the costs of rendering dental services. But what we discovered over time is that there were so many other problems to solve in dental insurance that we couldn't just solve the one that we thought we were solving. We needed to solve a bunch of problems simultaneously, and that led us to want to build our own dental insurance company.
Yeah, now, I said you weren't on everybody's radar, but that's kind of what I think is happening in the market and not really what the case is, because Beam Dental is making some noise on the coast and in the Midwest, and you don't scale to 200 employees unless your future is bright. You're up for an award tonight. How do you feel about that, man?
Super excited. I mean, from my perspective, the growth and the development of the venture community and the entrepreneur community and the founder community in Ohio and in Columbus and in the Midwest is really exciting. And the momentum's clear. You would not be doing what you're doing right now, and I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing right now 5 years ago in a place like Columbus. And so I think the trajectory is super clear. Just to be considered one of the people helping impact a market like this is really exciting. And I think our whole team is excited to be in a company that's being recognized by outsiders as something that's like, this is a problem we're solving and a company worth working at and something really interesting. We think that's phenomenal.
Flo, thank you so much for joining me on the red carpet. You're a good guy, plus a great founder, and I'm rooting for you to win this award tonight. Thank you so much.
Thanks for the ASAP designation.
Oh yeah, definitely. You earned it.
Thanks, too.